Good afternoon, Kandalkar madam.
Good afternoon, my dear Mita.
It's nice to have you for the interview today, which is being conducted under the auspices of Dr. M.V.L.Kothari, Chair of Medical Humanities, under the banner of Legions of GS Medical College and KM Hospital. Welcome to KM Hospital back, madam.
Thank you so much for having me.
First of all, let me ask you, madam, just tell us about your family background, your schooling and your college education, etc., your family, etc.
My mother and father, and I have four siblings. We have four siblings, two brothers, one elder sister, me, and two younger brothers, four of us. My father was a stickler for education. So he was posted in a remote place away from Hyderabad, where there were hardly any good schools. We being born in the early post-independent India era, I think that generation parents were very particular about education. So my father put us, all four of us, in Hyderabad in the best of comforts at that time. So I got my schooling right from KG up to the 10th in a convent called the St. Anne's Convent, Secretariat, which today is still today is considered amongst the best schools in Asia. And I had an Indian school certificate board. I didn't have an SSC board even at that time. It was an equivalent to a junior Cambridge. So my whole schooling went in hostels run by Italian nuns. And that's all thanks to my dad. He was a very particular that the kids should get a good education.
Then how did you decide to go for medicine, madam?
It was a natural thing for me. It was always that I wanted to do medicine. And it's not even that I'm one of those ambitious people who can think ahead too much. But I don't know how, somehow for medicine it was always there. And when I finished school, Indian school certificate should get in directly into medicine. That more. But
You didn't have to do FY science.
If we got the good marks, we didn't have to.
Oh, okay.
But I did not get the good marks. And at that time, there was a huge agitation in Telangana for a separate state. This was in 1969-70. It went on, it was the most massive, it was agitation. What happened recently was nothing. And then the whole of Andhra universities were closed for almost more than a year. So my father, being what he is, education is concerned, he took me to the nearest university outside Andhra, and that was Nagpur, where we live. That's how I came to Nagpur University, got BSc Part 1 there. Gave entrance exam, multiple entrance exams. I was getting in Nagpur Medical College itself, but I didn't have a domicile for Maharashtra. So the next university was Sevagram Mahatma College, College of Medical Sciences. And I got in there.
Oh, wow. And why did you choose pathology, madam, after?
Pathology because our second MBBS teacher, we had one Dr. R.V. Agarwal, who later on went to be the professor at BJ Medical College. Dr. Agarwal, who used to conduct most of the MAPCONs in those days, MAPCONs like seminars and all. He was a superb teacher. Superb means superb. No other description for him. And so humble, so humane, so kind. And the way he taught pathology was excellent. And that, there only. As so I said, I really not somebody who plans ahead, but I loved pathology.
Wow.
And I did my whole second MBBS only on his notes.
Wow.
It was so good. Although we did have boys, but still.
Any other teachers or any of your classmates or friends influenced you during your college life in medical school?
To be honest, I entered medical college at 17. I really never stayed at home as such because my whole schooling went in hospital. So I was too young to be influenced by anybody else. It was just my father who was the influence on me.
Yeah, did you participate in any extracurricular activities?
Lots.
Oh,
I used to play a lot of table tennis,
wow,
badminton, dramatics,
ah,
used to have plays in school, nothing professional or anything. but a lot of the dancing. We had a very good trained Kathak dancer, one of my friends in the same batch. So any college annual, anything, she used to always see that we all danced with her. And we really enjoyed.
And then how did you land up in Nair, in the
medical college? I landed up in Nair because at that time, my college where I did my MBBS, it was a new budding college, it didn't have post-graduation. And having come from Nagpur University, I had access to all the Maharashtra universities. So Bombay was a natural choice and I could get into pathology at that time.
So any teacher, I'm not teachers, yeah, but teachers or you know colleagues whom you would want to fondly talk about from Nair?
So wherever I work, since you know that I worked in all the three institutes, I had excellent heads of the department. Dr. Prabhu in Nair. Dr. Murthy was my guide, who later on separated to microbiology. Dr. Randive in Sain and D.R.S. Pandey Madam later on came in Nair. I was fortunate to have all these three very dedicated ladies in pathology and the way they used to work for the department. Maybe initially I was too young, but later on I still remember how Prabhu Madam would struggle to get for a good microscope. Yeah, this Pandey Madam would try her best to you know upgrade the department to more academics. Same with Randive Madam, CME, obviously. All that I think really helped me when I finally joined them. Because they were genuinely good.
And Madam, how about your research activities and you know any academic publications, academic activities, etc.?
Honestly, on the research part, I don't think I have a great footing into that. I've really not done much because our routine was such that we are busy with our usual routine work itself. But I put my heart and soul into academics, whatever came my way. I dealt with it to the best of my capability. And whatever we could publish, because in our early days, publications and all was not so much of a... It was not so encouraging or anything like that. But yes, as and when anything interesting did come along, I have always done it and maybe today a very modest 55 to 60 publications I hope we have.
Yeah, so then I think people could do the publications leisurely and you know out of interest. Today, right. Some of us are forced right. to do to right. get those. Right. So you think that's a good thing to do? I mean, almost like compulsory publications.
No. The only advantage of those compulsory publications is that you know how to go about something. If you do want to do something, you know how to go about it.
So it has advantages, disadvantages, both. And Madam, how did you like your tenure of almost 10 years in KM?
I loved it. I came here with a lot of apprehension because when I did get the chance to join here, it was just about 4.5 to 5 years remaining. But throughout my career, I never said no to any of the academic challenges that came up. So in that same spirit, like how I entered Sain, I think Sain trained me very well. You know, how to manage things because Dr. Ranjivya gave me a full free hand there. So when I stepped in, I was definitely apprehensive because I didn't know anybody that way knowing. But then it was like all of the challenges I just said, I think that my hostel background of so many years really helped me to face anything. So I came here and all of you were there so very affectionately, showed me everything, helped me in everything. And I must say Amita, she never refused anything that I asked for. She was always there to support me. Whatever it was, whether
you didn't ask for any difficult things anyway.
But whatever it is, you know, many times somebody can make life difficult, but you never did that. And my whole department also, somehow, and I saw your stories that, I don't know if I have to say this on camera, but some previous heads had difficult situations, I never had. Everything was nice, everybody was good, and I grew in KM. I learned so much, because there's so much material here, much more than what I saw in Nair or Sain, and that also helped me. And being the head, you want to see everything before you attend a meeting. I had that thing in me, whether it's a MAPCOM, whether it's a senior surgical or a department meeting. So that also helped me learn more. The compulsion that I must see before I head the meeting.
Great.
That really helped.
And madam, you contributed a lot to the department. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your contributions to the department?
I don't think I could talk about it myself. But just I can think of something which may have helped the department a lot. One is that MD transfusion medicine. Like we got an MD transfusion medicine which made blood banking separate from pathology. So that the pathology department can grow by itself and transfusion medicine has to grow as a separate way. That was one thing. Then I was lucky that we had a dean like Dr. Hope who encouraged us to start fellowships. So different organ pathology fellowships were started in the department, about 9 of them I think at the university level. Then one thing which I feel I started in the department was the immunohistochemistry, which was essential in pathology. And one thing which I feel was a very important thing that happened was that we tried to get more lecturers.
Yes.
From 8 lecturers we went on to 14, and that was a huge jump because the department needed it. Such a heavy workload compared to NIAC and we were having much less number of lecturers. They had more work and we had more work and less lecturers as compared to the other principals. So these are some of the things, and I tried to modernize, get in as many new instruments as possible, modernize histopath, and try to bring in the Wi-Fi system, try to bring in computers, the internet connection, whatever little was possible.
Great. And madam, did the department give you anything in return?
Yes, everything. I grew here. I became so confident when I left here, so that when I was offered this new job, to set up the pathology department at this children's hospital at Hajjem, I knew exactly what I was going to do. I started from scratch. I had no hesitation, no fear, because I got the confidence here that I can handle anything there. Right from purchasing instrument, recruiting people, what sections to set up, what techniques to set up, how to go about it, how to budget, what to ask for. It looked like I could manage it.
Please tell us something about your colleagues in KEM hospital and students and PG students, UG and PG.
I always say God has been kind to me. I have met the best of people, right from Dr. Manu Kothari, who was always so loving towards me. He would phone and say, "Gunu, this is Manu." So Manu Kothari sir and Rupa ma'am took me in their wing right from the beginning, and somehow that acted like a shield, I think, because when you are outside, you think KM is, oh my god, this is all wouldn't happen. But it was nothing like that. They were so loving and they introduced me to so many people like Dr. Ravi Ramakantan, Dr. Atul Boyd. All of them used to be with sir and ma'am. So whenever sir would call me, many times they would be there. I came to know that. So this is outside my department. And within the department, you're always so nice to me. Amita and all the other juniors, they were so very good to me. I didn't have any problem
in managing
at all. And anything I had, I would immediately ask you also. Even Leena was there, a colleague who I knew right from my days. Whatever others may be in their personalities towards each other, with me, there was always obedience. I never got the aggression or the anti-ness, never.
And madam, do you think there is any difference between the UG students of NIAR, SIAN and KEM, or are they similar, same?
I think they are similar. So I was a long time in NIAR too, short time in SIAN, but I was always involved in undergraduate teaching, like over here also, lectures and all that.
And PGs also, because the workload is far more for residents in KEM compared to other colleges.
Yes, PGs also. Each one has their own plus and minus. PGs also, because each one gets a good exposure in each of the institutes. Maybe the exposure here in certain things is little more, like more biopsy pathology, like GI, maybe little more than what. Otherwise,
yes, similar. You have any guidance for us for future of the department, or you know, something that we
my
must
guidance,
start.
As I always say, is if you are heading the department, only think of the department. Anything you do, any of your actions should be, how will it benefit my department? How is it going to gain from there? And then yes.
Anything you feel that we should start, any newer tests or anything that we must, which can be easily accommodated or something.
Newer techniques, let's see, like when, because of my new hospital, I have seen, I was never exposed to immunofluorescence. Never. Recently we got an autoimmune specialist, Dr. Kuchalla, who once walked into my department and just said, I need this specimen because I'm going to join you. They were all ANA, ELISA, and I was wondering, my God, I've never ever been exposed to this in all my 38 years in the BMC. But let's see how we can go about it. I asked for an immunofluorescent attachment. I think AM already has that.
Yeah.
And they're very simple tests. I keep wondering, why the hell do we outsource them to outside? They're so simple. And I got training from a microbiologist how to read that ANA, BMA. It's so simple, Amita.
Wow. Okay.
But I keep wondering, why didn't we? But then there are so many other things maybe to do. So there's only so much you can do and not more. So those immunofluorescence tests, the ELISA tests, they're so simple. You know, anti-cardiac, lupin, antibody, you think there's something great, there's nothing.
But are they expensive?
They're not expensive. So that's what I think we can easily start.
Sure, madam, I will definitely take this advice and you know.
It's ANA and DSDNA. If at all you have a department who wants those tests.
That sounds good, madam. Because you've seen,
yes,
worked in this
yes,
department and
yes.
So you exactly know, you love this department.
Yes.
So you exactly know where, how we can
right.
head and where
right.
we can head to.
Share some memorable experience.
In the department? A memorable experience?
Yeah. Anything we can remember.
All my memories are, I don't know, all of them are good. All the CMEs we had, I think that's something I will always remember. How we used to work together. All of us together for those CMEs, like a family, like a party, filling bags around this table over here. And memorable was also when the renovation was occurring. Lot of adjustments the departments had to do, how to manage in the makeshift department. Like, everything was nice, worth cherishing. The Dashara function we used to have all together as a family.
Any specific episode you can think of, maybe? Yeah.
I had a nice time there. Everything was good.
What about your relationship with
forensic medicine?
I think you had a good
relationship with forensic medicine.
I fortunately had a person in forensic medicine like Dr. Walter Vaz, who was a very strict in work, in ethics, in his timing. So although many patho departments have trouble, honestly speaking, trouble getting along with their forensic colleagues on so many things, I was lucky in having Dr. Vaz, who was particular about timing, about what is medico-legal and what is medical. He would not, you know, shove off his work onto us. And he was interested in academics. So that way I had a nice relation. With microbiology, although I knew Preeti very well personally, as such patho-micro don't have that much things together except for classes, sharing classrooms and having exams and all those things together. But work-wise, as such, we didn't have much in common.
Madam, can you tell us something about anecdote or, you know, some important episode which was quite funny or, you know, worth remembering or something.
We were trying for MD transfusion medicine in this institute as a separate entity from pathology. So, Rajni ma'am, myself and Dr. Ray, three of us went to the then AMC, who was in charge of hospitals, Mr. Rajni, and submitted our file. We had done the same thing 1 month before, but at that time they were not entertained. This time when we went, we were very lucky. One DMC corporator, powerful person who had said, Mr. Pedro Sakkar. So, and we happened to recognize Jetri and Dr. Ray immediately. So I think he comes here often to take blood for his patients. So as soon as we put up our case, and before Mr. Gajbiya could say anything, Mr. Sakpal immediately said, Sahib, Devon Taka hai na hai, Parvangi Devon Taka, Mandira Acha Pujari pe ekstra changla kama karta hai.
Wow.
So that one sentence, I think,
that's the biggest certificate that
Mr. Gajbiya sort of agreed to our proposal, and there and then he signed after. And they were out. Only we had to submit it for some other formalities.
Wow.
And that was the beginning of the transfusion medicine in Kerala. And in the whole of Maharashtra, I think.
And any message you would like to give to the undergraduate and postgraduate students of Kerala Hospital?
Nothing like hard work to go up the ladder. It's all like okay. Honesty and hard work gives you everything. Everything that you need.
Absolutely. That is a brilliant message by you, madam. Madam has truly been legendary head of department for pathology. As she said, you know, she started the immunohistochemistry. She procured a lot of machines. She made sure that the reagents and everything was in place, and there was a continuous supply of all the reagents so that the tests didn't have to be stopped. She conducted a lot of CMEs. She conducted the autopsy workshops which were stopped, so she revived them. So she has contributed a lot to the department. Of course, madam didn't say it herself. But
we put it together.
Yeah, yes, of course. The department was definitely, we all were happy that, you know, somebody like her is leading us. So we could work with a lot of enthusiasm under her guidance and under her leadership. Thank you very much, madam, for
having me here. Thank you so much.